What is up, YouTube? Luca here with another PvP build for the Blackwood chapter. Back to my Magicka Necromancer, but this time with a pure AoE burst setup. On the back bar, I've been trying Iron Blood. This set has a downside and a benefit side. Positive thing is 30% damage reduction. That's like the old major protection. Insanely high mitigation. Downside, it snares you for 50%. I've played it for a couple of hours. Open field, kinda bad because you need the movement, otherwise you can't survive. But in close range fights, like in towers, inner keeps, behind crates and that kind of stuff, it's perfectly for this build because you want to stack as many targets as possible in a close corner to be able to burst them down. On the front bar, the Master's Lightning stuff, it gives us over 600 spell damage and converts the clench to shock clench, so it's an AoE spammable, pretty damn strong. You have to stack your enemies as close as possible, otherwise you will not hit everyone because the AoE is kind of small. It's not like Pulsar, for example. Talking about Pulsar, you could alternative use the Black Rose Prison, Lightning or Inferno stuff here. On the body, Burning Spareweave, a pretty decent set. It gives almost 500 spell damage. The proc condition is to deal flame damage, which is pretty easy on a Magicka Necromancer still without an Inferno stuff. You only need to use the Stalking Blast Bolts or Burst spammable, which deals flame damage. As Monster said, Zoal or Zoal the Ever Wakeful. It gives you automatically a AoE fear if you see C-Break. And you also gain 34 weapon and spell damage for each enemy you hit, up to 6 enemies at maximum. So another over 200 spell damage for 7 seconds. I'm trying to use different setups at the moment, not always the same, like Balorg, Pariah, Armor Master, that kind of stuff. There are so many options in this game. The amount of available sets are insanely high. You have probably 1k sets out there. Most of them are shit, but there are a couple of kind of interesting and useful sets that I'm trying to test with different characters. That means stay tuned for a ton of more PvP builds or in general PvP content. I will not stop, guys, don't worry. If you continue to smash the like buttons and my sub button, I can keep going, posting almost every day one or two videos. Only for you, my friends, only for you. Let's take a quick look on the skills. Front bar, Agony Totem. It gives minor protection if you stand in a circle. It fears the enemy after 2 seconds and gives minor vulnerability if someone uses the synergy. Pretty damn strong. For single target fights, if you're solo, I would recommend to use Elemental Drain. But in groups, we always have caltrops for Major Breach. Then Stalking Blast Bolts. It procs Burning Spareweave since it does flame damage. Shock Clench, our AoE spammable. Then Avid Boneyard for the own synergy. Pretty strong. Inner Light for extra sustain and max magicka. Then Colossus as ultimate. Back bar Rapid Regeneration. Our Hot. Race Against Time. Our Snare removable. It gives Major Expedition and Minor Force. Another 30% movement speed and 10% more crit damage. Resistance Flash. Our Burst Heal. Then Summoner's Armor. Our Resistance Buff. Spirit Guardian. For extra healing and 10% damage mitigation. And as defensive ultimate, the Goliath. Alternative, you could go with the Restoration ultimate here. As race, I'm Khajiit for extra 12% crit damage. High Elf, Dunmore, Nord, Imperial are fine too, depends on the playstyle. This is also my PvE char, that's why he's Khajiit, to be honest. But the 12% extra crit damage is kinda nice without mana cut. As Mundus, the Lord Mundus. Otherwise, our HP is too low. 15 points in HP, by the way, and 49 max magicka. As Bafo, the Clockwork Citrus Filet. for extra sustain. Potions, most of the time, the normal spell power potions with Magicka, Major Sorcery, and Major Prophecy. And sometimes the detection potions. Then CPs, blue ones are Mastered Arms, Biting Aura, Resilience, and Duelist Rebuff. Red ones, Rejuvenation, Slippery, Dagonaut, and Ironclad. By the way, traits and glyphs. I slack on stones at the moment, that's why I have 2 divines and 1 training piece. It would be better with 5 impen and 2 well fitted, by the way. Then on the jewelry, fully infused with 2 spell damage glyphs and 1 magic cost reduction glyph. On the front by a sharpened lightning staff, the master staff, with the berserker glyph. On the back bar, a defending restoration staff with this poison seer for extra sustain and to apply minor cowardice, so 215 weapon and spell damage less for the enemies. Now, with some gameplay footage with my small skill boys, Papa Chico and Jonas, after a couple of hours, we had some decent fights that I wanted to show you. Enjoy, guys and girls.
Bittersweet and I'm walking slow. Sensitive, feel the afterglow. Looking for things that I can't control. Fear from my past, cause it always shows. Do I wanna try? Can I let it go? Running from the past, wanting to be sure. Chaos in my mind, constant deja vu. But every time it comes back to you. Whoa, I'm still falling. Whoa, but it tastes bittersweet. Whoa, I keep on falling. Whoa, I like the taste of it.
That's it for this PvP build. Stay tuned for more PvP builds. In 1 or 2 days I will upload another one. Don't know which character and which build, but we will see them. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, and I see you hopefully in the next video. Ciao!